It's the Gilda Sue Rosenstern Computer Internet Show.
Thanks for joining us, lovelies. I'm Gilda Sue Rosenstern. I'm just tickled pink to be back from celebrating Yom Kippur. And now we're celebrating Halloween, also known as Samhain, which some people mistakenly call Samhain, which, as it turns out, happens to be the name of my Bobeshi's Texas swing dance instructor. Now, as faithful viewers may know, I have been dealing with some mighty big pickles in my personal life, but as you might be happy to hear, I have indeed decided to stay with Shalom Beth Temple and Rabbi Spiderman, and I even believe I've decided whom to vote for in this year's presidential election. But now, I do have a new pickle to deal with, and that is the question of Yom Kippur itself and what to do about all of my sinning. Now, as some of y'all may know, my mama is indeed a not-Jew. As a matter of fact, every Sunday, she goes to the First Baptist Church twice removed, right here in my neighborhood. So, being a half-Jew, the bottom half, I celebrate half the Jewish holidays, and the Christian half of me, the top half, celebrates half the Christian ones. And as y'all may be able to tell, I am currently in training to also be half witch. Now, y'all, as any good Jew on Yom Kippur, I did spend some time afflicting my soul in accordance with Jewish tradition, but y'all, that gets old fast. Luckily for me, both Jews and Christians are real big on punishing yourself and guilt and all that, so I had some options. Now, in my mama's church, the Baptists, they teach once you are saved, you are always saved. But they do work in that troublesome concept of backsliding just to keep you on your toes. So, y'all, I decided to deal with all of my sinning the Catholic way. Which, yes, is fair game, as far as I'm concerned. Ever since that genealogist told my poor mama about that Irish Catholic great-great-granny of hers. So, instead of spending all that time afflicting my soul and listening to Rabbi Spiderman go on and on and on about bulls and rams and goats and all, which, by the way, are highly sacred to witches, I decided just to go on across the street to Our Lady of Perpetual Conflict, fess up and get it over with. Talk about easy. I just had to tell some priest in a closet all the stuff I pretend to be ashamed of, cross myself, do a little recitation, and I still made it to bitch in time for strip trivia. Y'all, I may just have to give up Yom Kippur altogether as it's become so complicated. Maybe I'll just trade it in and do Hanukkah twice. And then maybe I'll just give up one thing permanently, like a filter fish. Then I could just celebrate Halloween all year long and revel in the fun things in life instead of giving up the fun things in life. Now remember, lovelies, Judaism and Christianity may get in the way of your witchcraft, but witchcraft never gets in the way of your Judaism and Christianity. Trick or treat, y'all!
Buff, buff.